Kwok-hung has now moved a motion to adjourn. According to the rules of procedure, I must first of all deal with this motion. Mr. Leung, please be seated. I now put a question to you, and that is, Mr. Leung Kwok-hung, in relation to the joint debate that we are carrying on, would like to move a motion that the meeting, that the discussion be adjourned. In accordance with Rule 45, the motion cannot be amended. I now invite members and the officials to speak on the motion to adjourn. Secretary, would you like to speak? Mr. President, I would like to give a simple reply. For the CSA moved by Wu Chi-wai, he's referring to certain cases. For the figures that I have got with me, among the 5,000 TPS cases, 60 of them involved non-Hong Kong PR buyers or sellers. So they have to pay the BSD. And then under this bill, we have got the AVD. So as part of our policy, a Hong Kong resident who is a first-time buyer will be exempted. And this is applicable to the tenant purchase scheme for the 60 cases that I have referred to. For the BSD, the amount of money involved is rather substantial. So members are concerned, and there has been discussion with the IRD. The IRD has been dealing with the cases in a discretionary manner. Now, here we are having a debate about the AVD. If we are to exempt the TPS buyers, now to me, I don't think the help is substantial. I think the main problem is with the BSD, the buyer's stamp duty. So the cases are different. Each of them is unique. That is why they don't buy in the name of a Hong Kong PR and so be exempted. I don't know why they can't get the exemption, and therefore they have to pay the BSD. So for us, we believe that the cases have to be dealt with on their individual merits. Now, for the administration, for this AVD, we believe that it is not right for us to give a blanket exemption. This is because when we first considered the matter, first-time home buying of Hong Kong PR should be exempted from the doubled AVD. And then for older flats, they are of a lower value and they are sort of affordable to the lower income class. For the integrity of our policy, anybody who's buying their first home will be exempted. Now, we are talking about individual cases. If we are to give exemption under the TPS, then to the other citizens, it will be regarded as unfair because they also buy an older flat and they wonder why they should not be exempted. So in terms of the integrity of the policy, we have to give consideration to this point. Now, for Wu Chi-wai and others, they have referred to specific cases. We did follow them up, and the Bills Committee has also followed them up. I think we should exercise discretion. I don't think even with the CSA from Wu Chi-wai, we can offer much assistance because they still have to pay the BSD. We have to find out more about the details. The best way is to deal with it in this way.
Yeah.
So it's not the best way to deal with it is not to exempt the AVD. It's not that the administration hasn't considered this case, but just that perhaps we have different viewpoints when we look at this issue. Members asked, how come we do not exempt just a handful these cases because there are so few in number? But then there are similar situation for other handful of cases. if we just look at the number of cases and then offer any legal exemption, then there will no longer be equity for the piece of legislation concerned. That's why, to be pragmatic, we should deal with it case by case. Actually, for these 60 cases, even if they are given exemption from DSD, they don't benefit much. The real issue is about the buyer's stamp duty, BSD. Now, we have a long debate on this issue since 9 a.m. this morning. And under the circumstance, I think members have all heard the views of different persons. I've made clear the administration's position. I hope I can convince you, but if you're not convinced, still, I would suggest that at this point, please do not adjourn this item. Please continue to speak and vote on this item. And so we could take things forward. Now, I do not know if we could put this to a vote today, but I hope members will have regard to the overall progress of the bill. We've already said a lot on this item, so please proceed with the debate and the vote. Before I invite other members to speak, if I may remind members, we are now dealing with a motion moved by Mr. Leung Kwok-hung in accordance with Rule 45 to adjourn the debate of proceedings of a committee of the whole council. Now, if this motion is passed and in accordance with the rules of procedure, the committee of the whole council must revert to the whole council, and we can no longer process the Stamp Duty Amendment Bill 2013 until the relevant official gives notice to resume processing of the bill. Mr. Chairman, can I ask a question, because this is important? Now, if the administration is to give notice to resume discussion of the bill, as you mentioned, could the administration do so without notice, as long as you give leave for them not to waive the notice, because that's very important? Mr. Leung, let me explain this to you all. Council is now in committee to consider the Stamp Duty Amendment Bill 2013. If this motion of adjournment is passed, then we will resume, the council will resume immediately, and we cannot deal with this bill, and we will move on to the next item of business on the agenda. In other words, we will move on to the marriage bill. And at this council meeting, we could no longer consider the Stamp Duty Amendment Bill that we are now considering. Of course, the notice period could be waived. There is a 5 days notice period. The administration could give notice, but we have to call another council meeting. Otherwise, we'll have to wait till after the summer recess in October before we could consider the bill again. That is, if we pass this motion of adjournment of debate of a committee of the whole council, that is the consequence. So I want members to get that right. Mr. Sin Chung Kai, Mr. Chairman, I don't think you've explained yourself clearly. I understand the chief executive could write to you and ask you to convene another meeting. I don't think you've given the full explanation. Mr. Leung Kwok-hung, please take your seat. Yes, of course, if there is an urgent business, LegCo could always convene special meetings. If the chief executive sees the need, he could ask this council to convene special meetings. Secretary, having heard the chairman, I understand that if this motion of adjournment is passed, there would be a serious delay to this stamp duty bill. Well, Mr. Leung has moved this motion. Is there any room for him to withdraw his motion? Because all the members are here anyway. And I think there are enough members here to continue discussion of this bill. I wonder if there is any room for Mr. Leung to withdraw his motion. Yes, Mr. Chairman, that's the point I'd like to make. Officials, are in high position. They could ask for time from you. They could ask for 30 minutes. We are supposed to exercise check and balance with them, but if they don't submit anything to us, there's no point having a meeting. Mr. Leung Kwok-hung, you have moved a motion. Unless you withdraw your motion now, because the motion has been moved, if you wish to withdraw the motion, there must be no objection from members before you could withdraw the motion. And if you do not withdraw the motion, then we must proceed to a debate of the motion, so in accordance with the rules of procedure. Can I ask you this, Mr. Chairman? If I withdraw the motion, can I move it again, or can someone else move this motion again in this council meeting, in this committee? The rules of procedure does not state that you cannot move the same motion again in this meeting. Well, in that case, I declare that I would withdraw this motion. The reason is I would like to give time to for Professor K.C. Chen to ask John Zhang whether a concession could be made. I will reserve my right. I will proceed to speak on other items. I hope the administration will talk to the FTU and others to make a concession. Otherwise, I will move another motion to adjourn the debate. Mr. Leung Kwok-hung has moved a motion of adjournment of debate. Now, Mr. Leung asks to withdraw the motion. For members present, any objection, please? Mr. James Toh. Point of order, Mr. Chairman. Now, of course, if there is, say, a break of 30 minutes, then the administration should allow the administration to move an amendment exactly the same as Mr. Wichiwai, with you giving leave to waive notice. And if there is no unfairness involved, then the president would have reasons to give such leave. Now, Mr. Leung Kwok-hung, once he withdraws his motion of adjournment, can I ask if this is the case? That is, during the committee stage on this bill, there cannot be other motions to be moved on the adjournment of the debate? No, I already said it's not the case. He's moved the motion, but he's withdrawing it before there's any debate or voting. So later on in the committee, if there are same motions moved again, it's not against the rules of procedure. Mr. Chairman, point of order. At this point, who could ask the chairman to adjourn the meeting for a short period of time? Or any member could make the request and I will consider it. Anyway, I've heard the request. Can I first ask the committee to deal with Mr. Leung's request to withdraw his motion of adjournment of debate? Any objection, please? No? Then I declare that Mr. Leung Kwok-hung has withdrawn his motion on adjournment of debate. Now, in response to members' request, I adjourn the meeting for 15 minutes.